What is the TARDIS? Let's explain that time machine that Doctor Who travels in, the infamous blue box. The TARDIS stands for Time and Relative Dimension in Space, and it functions as the Doctor's time machine and spacecraft. Now, the TARDIS is much larger on the inside than it is on the outside, and that's a running gag in the entire series. The inside of the TARDIS will also change to whatever the Doctor would like it to be. So with each regeneration, the Doctor has had a different interior appearance, another way to keep the sets updated and not looking like they're from the 60s. The amount of rooms and the exact size of the interior is completely unknown, as it can change and move around to whatever it sees fit. The Doctor also has the ability to delete and create new rooms as he sees fit in the TARDIS. In the episode The Doctor's Wife, it was proven that if someone is in a deleted room as it's getting deleted, they'll get moved to the main control room. He can also take any of the current rooms and move them as he needs, like when the 11th Doctor moved the swimming pool right beneath the TARDIS's entrance to catch River Song in the Day of the Moon. The size of the TARDIS interior has also been mentioned in tie-in novels, and it's been said to contain an entire city, an entire parallel Earth, and it's supposedly larger than Gallifrey itself when it's turned inside out. It can also exist in multiple timelines as it needs to. And in the episode, The Journey to the Center of the TARDIS, it's shown to contain the Eye of Harmony, an exploding star that is going to become a black hole very soon. So, suffice to say, the interior can be whatever they need it to be and house whatever is needed to be housed for the sake of a good Doctor Who story. Now, the exterior is probably one of the largest questions you have. It has the ability to change its outer appearance to match whatever time period and planet that it is currently on. But the Doctor's TARDIS is broken, and back in the first episode, they mention how it was supposed to have a shape-changing ability, but it doesn't seem to be working. This may be due to the fact that the Doctor stole it from the repair yard with his granddaughter, meaning that it was already prone to having problems. This shape-changing circuit that changes the appearance of the TARDIS is known as the chameleon circuit in most canon things. Now, the reason why the Doctor stole the TARDIS is something that isn't referred to too often. The novels have touched on a few ideas, such as he was fleeing from his accuser who blamed him of loom jumping, he was also fleeing from a revolt at the Time Lord Academy, even though he was innocent, or perhaps it was the reason that they gave where he broke the laws of non-interference that the Time Lords put into place. Now, the idea that he broke the laws of non-interference has been kind of reaffirmed in the second Doctor serials, as when he returns home he's put on trial for interfering with history and breaking the laws of time. Either way, the first Doctor and Susan, his granddaughter, stole a faulty TARDIS. The Doctor has throughout the generations tried multiple times to fix the chameleon circuit so that it would be able to change its appearance properly again, but by the time we get to the 8th Doctor, he says that he's grown fond of the blue box and he stopped trying to fix it a while ago, and the 9th Doctor reaffirmed this notion. Now, the exterior can lock itself to people who aren't the Doctor, and it can also turn itself invisible when it needs to, like when it was hiding from Nixon and Area 51 in The Impossible Astronaut. The exterior doors have also been changed as the series goes on. Originally, it contained an exterior set of doors and then an interior set to the control room. But as of the reboot, now the exterior goes right into the control room. One of the more interesting facts about the TARDIS is that it appears to be alive to some extent. It has been implied that the TARDIS will take the biological imprint from the first Time Lord to actually use it, allowing the pilot to survive in time travel and keep misuse of the TARDIS from getting out. Because of this, the TARDIS will act on its own at times to help or save its pilot, which it's done for the Doctor in the past. Now, this sentience has actually been removed and placed into a body of a woman in the episode The Doctor's Wife, written by Neil Gaiman of Sandman fame. It has also given itself a holographic appearance at times to be able to properly talk to the Doctor when needed, which was proven in the episode Let's Kill Hitler. Clara Oswald has also spoken to a holographic interface when the TARDIS locked her out, and this animosity between her and the ship continues until we find out that it was Clara Oswald who traveled through the Doctor's timeline to ensure that the first Doctor and Susan stole that TARDIS. There are plenty more instances of things that the TARDIS has done and what it's capable of, but suffice to say, with all of its systems and its own sentience, it's basically able to do anything that's needed to facilitate a story. So what's your favorite TARDIS moments? Let me know in the comments down below, and I'll see you guys right here next time at Comicstorian.